Hi and welcome, you're watching Reporter's Take. This is Vaibhavi Khanwalkar. The US withdrew the GSP benefit, which was the generalized system of preferences, which allowed for duty-free preferential imports. And now that it has been rescinded, we know that the drug makers from India who used to export to the US have been hit. And now Vishwanath is joining us. He's going to give us more details about this. Vishwanath, hi, thank you so much for joining us. So can you tell us what the likely impact of the GSP withdrawal is going to be?
Well, Vaibhavi, India exported pharmaceuticals worth $6.3 billion in 2018 to US.
Okay.
So the removal of GSP or the withdrawal will have an impact of 4 to 5% on the margins, sales margins of the companies.
Right.
I mean the margins in the US are very healthy, in the range of 35 to 40% for Indian companies.
Okay.
And in some cases it will go up more than 60% if there is some kind of an exclusivity.
Okay.
So there will be a certain impact on the margins of...
Sure, so we can expect some impact now, but it has happened. So what is it that the companies are doing to mitigate the risks that they might face?
So the companies have two options. One is they have to pass on the cost that has been added to the customers. And second is to work on their cost structures to reduce their cost. So these are the two. But Indian companies will be able to fairly do it because around 40% of drugs sold in generic drugs sold in US are originated from India.
Okay.
So the India cost advantage will not go away very soon. So still they'll be able to take this hit.
Right. So we know that GSP has been withdrawn, and there's of course a lot of reasons that it must have happened. But how much do you think US trade lobbies had to do with this?
So two of the lobbies, one is the AdvaMed, which represents the medical devices, and PHRMA, which represents the pharmaceutical companies. Both have been insisting on the US government or USTR, US trade representatives, to revoke or to withdraw the GSP benefits accorded to India. I mean, there, for instance, the AdvaMed grouse is that the Indian government went ahead and capped the prices of cardiac stents and knee implants.
Sure, sure.
So if you look at it, around one, I mean, US exported $1.6 billion worth of medical devices to India.
So they
are saying that, you know, because of this price caps and price controls, India is not providing an equitable market access to the to the US companies.
Okay.
And the pharma lobby has a very different reasons. They are not happy with the patent regime or the compulsory licensing option, which is a legitimate option as per WTO agreement.
Okay.
And the third, I mean, they're generally unhappy with the price controls as well.
Okay, well, thank you so much for those insights, Vishvi. With that, it's a wrap on this edition of Reporter's Take. For more such news and views, stay logged on to moneycontrol.com. Thanks for watching.